The University of Memphis has responded to Tom Bowen, right? So if you missed the shows earlier in the week, you can go back and watch them. I don't want to rehash the whole thing. But Tom Bowen resigned from the University of Memphis as AD. It still had time left on his contract. They had a weird six-month extension back in March. His contract was due up in June. They re-upped him for 6 months, and their excuse was because they didn't know what the AAC's TV deal was going to look like. So they get all that stuff done, blah, 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 blah. Well, he resigns. Story comes out that there was a letter that was sent to the university president, Dr. David Rudd. And in that letter, there were allegations of maybe some shady stuff going on with another university employee, a female employee, where they are flirty. They are, you know, she's getting his hotel key early. They always sit together at different functions, et cetera, right? So that letter gets delivered to the university 4 days before Bowen resigns. Now, Bowen came out, all of this stuff came out in an open records request. So Freedom of Information Act, all that kind of stuff. The Daily Memphian is the one that did it. And all of this stuff comes out, and Bowen responds and says that the letter was never presented to him, it was never validated, and he said, you know, there's no truth to this, it's petty, it's ridiculous, I did not resign because of this. The university has come out and said he resigned in lieu of an investigation. Like, this is why he resigned. Now, if you were the university and that's not true, you are opening up a whole can of legal worms, right? Because you can be sued for this. You can have all of these things go on. It's a dangerous thing. Initially, you look at it and you think, if you're the university, just leave it alone. Like, I understand where you have to give documents like these to the press when they request. That's the reason they created the Freedom of Information Act. But, man, like, stay out of it. Give over the redacted one and then no comment. There's no reason to comment on this. It makes Bowen look bad. It makes the university look bad. But, my goodness, Bowen was up for the Southern Conference commissioner's job. I don't think there's any way that he can get that at this point, because what this entails, basically, in this letter is that there was a subordinate that worked at the university that may or may not have been having a relationship with Tom Bowen. That you can't get away from that in today's age, right? So there's a lot going on with this. It's going to get messier. It's going to get just really bad. And I feel like the University of Memphis maybe should have just no commented. But they've opened up the can of worms. We'll see what comes out of it. From there,